Hello, today we are reading from the Apocrypha from the book of 4th Maccabees, chapter 15, and it reads as follows. O reasoning of the sons, lord over the passions, and religion more desirable to a mother than progeny. The mother, when two things were set before her, religion and the safety of her 7 sons for a time, on the conditional promise of a tyrant, rather elected the religion, which according to God preserves to eternal life. Oh, in what way can I describe ethically the affections of parents toward their children, the resemblance of soul and of form engrafted into the small type of a child in a wonderful manner, especially through the greater sympathy of mothers with the feelings of those born of them, for by how much mothers are by nature weak in disposition and prolific in offspring, by so much the fonder they are of children. And of all mothers, the mother of the 7 was the fondest of children, who in 7 childbirths had deeply engendered love toward them, and through her many pains undergone in connection with each one, was compelled to feel sympathy with them. Yet through fear of God, she neglected the temporary salvation of her children, not but that on account of the excellent disposition to the law, her maternal affection toward them was increased. For they were both just and temperate, and manly and high-minded, and fond of their kindred, and so fond of their mother, that even to death they obeyed her by observing the law. And yet, though there were so many circumstances connected with love of children to draw on a mother of sympathy, in the case of none of them were the various tortures able to pervert her principle. But she inclined each one separately and altogether to death for religion. O holy nature and parental feeling, and reward of bringing up children, and unconquerable maternal affection, at the racking and roasting of each one of them, the observant mother was prevented by religion from changing. She saw her children's flesh dissolving around the fire, their extremities quivering on the ground, and the flesh of their heads drop forward down to their beards like masks. O you mother who was tried at this time with bitter pangs than those of parturition. You only women who have brought out perfect holiness. Your firstborn expiring turned you not, nor the second looking miserable in his torments, nor the third breathing out his soul, nor when you did behold the eyes of each of them looking sternly upon their tortures and their nostrils, foreboding death did you weep. When you did see the children's flesh heaped upon children's flesh, that had been torn off, heads decapitated upon heads, dead falling upon the dead, and a choir of children turned through torture into a burying ground, you lamented not. Not so do siren melodies or songs of swans attract the hearers to listening, O voices of children calling upon your mother in the midst of torments. With what and what manner of torments was the mother herself tortured, as her sons were undergoing the wheel and the fires. But religious reasoning having strengthened her courage in the midst of sufferings, enabled her to forego, for the time, parental love, although beholding the destruction of 7 children, the noble mother, after one embrace, stripped off her feelings through faith in God. For just as in a council room, beholding in her own soul vehement counselors, nature and parentage and love of her children, and the racking of her children, she holding 2 votes, one for the death, the other for the preservation of her children, didn't lean to that which would have saved her children for the safety of a brief space. But this daughter of Abraham remembered his holy fortitude. O holy mother of a nation, avenger of the law and defender of religion, and prime bearer in the battle of the affections. O you nobler in endurance in males, and more manly than men in perseverance, for as the ark of Noah bearing the world in the world-filling flood bore up against the waves, so you, the guardian of the law, when surrounded on every side by the flood of passions and straitened by violent storms, which were the torments of those children, did bear up nobly against the storms, against religion. If then even a woman in chapter 16, if then even a woman and that an aged one and the mother of 7 children endure to see her children's torment even to death, confessedly religious reasonings is master even of the passions, I have proved then that not only men have obtained the mastery of their passions, but also that a woman despised the greatest torments, and not so fierce were the lions round Daniel, nor the furnace of Masael burning with most vehement fires, as that natural love of children burned within her when she saw her seven sons tortured. But with the reasoning of religion, the mother quenched passion so great and powerful. For we must consider also this, that had the woman been faint-hearted as being their other, she would have lamented over them, and perhaps might have spoken like this, "Ah, wretched I, and many times miserable, who having borne seven sons, have become the mother of none. Oh, seven useless childbirths, and seven profitless periods of labor, and fruitless giving of suck, and miserable nursing at the breast. Vainly for your sakes, O sons, have I endured many pangs, and the more difficult anxieties of rearing. Alas, of my children, some of you unmarried, and some who have married to no profit, I will not see your children, nor be felicitated as a grandmother. Ah, that I, who had many and fair children, should be a lone widow full of sorrows. Nor should I die, will I have a son to bury me. But with such a lament at this, the holy and God-fearing mother mourned none of them. Nor did she divert any of them from death, nor grieve for them as for the dead, but as one possessed with an adamantine mind, and as one bringing out again her full number of sons to immortality, she rather with supplication exhorted them to death in behalf of religion. O woman, soldier of God, for religion, you, aged in a female, have conquered through endurance even a tyrant. And though but weak, have been found more powerful in deeds and words. For when you were seized, along with your children, you stood looking upon Eleazar in torments, and said to your sons in the Hebrew tongue, O sons, noble is the contest to which you, being called as a witness for the nation, strive zealously for the laws of your country. For it were disgraceful that this old man should endure pains for the sake of righteousness, and that you who are younger should be afraid of the tortures. Remember that through God you obtain existence and have enjoyed it, and on this second account you ought to bear every affliction because of God, for whom also our father Abraham was forward to sacrifice Isaac, our progenitor, and shuddered not at the sight of his own paternal hand descending down with the sword upon him. And the righteous Daniel was cast to the lions, and Ananias and Azarias and Mishael were slung out into a furnace of fire, yet they endured through God. You, then, having the same faith toward God, be not troubled. For it is unreasonable that they who know religion should not stand up against troubles. With these arguments, the mother of seven, exhorting each of her sons over, persuaded them from transgressing the commandment of God. And they saw this, too, that they who die for God live to God, as Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and all the patriarchs. Amen.